So very good evening, student. We are going to cover the numericals on gravitation. Okay, so we are going to solve the next question we had also covered in last class. Okay, so today we will cover the rest question. First question for today says a stone is thrown vertically in upward direction with the initial velocity of 40 meter per second. Okay, so suppose here we have the surface of earth, okay, and from here we have thrown any object vertically and its initial velocity was 40 meter per second. So it is a given part, so I am writing here u equals to, it is given, so I'm writing here given. So what is u? It is 40 meter per second. Okay, taking g as 10 meter per square second. So it says that g equals to 10. It is actually 9.8, but it is saying 10. So we have to take 10 only. It is meter per second square. Find the maximum height reaches by the stone. So we had to find h. Okay, what is the net displacement and the total distance covered by the stone? Okay, so we had to find that h into 2. That h is nothing but the displacement. We'll calculate that also. Okay, so let's there are two find part. So see, when object is over here and we have start like throwing that object in upward direction, so its initial velocity is 10. When it reaches to certain height, its final velocity will become 0. Okay, so v equals to 0 over here. Okay, so v will be 0 meter per second. Okay, so this is the given part. Okay, this is the given part. Here we have to find the h. Okay, now we are going to solve the question. Okay, and that displacement is nothing but the height. Is it or not? Yeah.
Yes, sir.
So, which equation we are going to use here for kinematic?
See, we v square equals to u square plus 2g.
Yes, the third equation of motion. Yes. So, I'm writing formula. So, what is formula? By the third kinematic equation, it is v square equals to u square plus 2as. This formula we are going to use. Okay, I am going to solve the question now. So, solution. Okay, so I'm again using the formula. It is v square equals c. We have thrown object vertically. So, when object is moving upward direction, that gravity is opposing that. So again, here we have to take g as negative. So I'm writing here negative 10 meter per square second. Okay. So v square equals to u square plus 2as. Okay. So now we are going to place the values. We have 0. So it is square of 0 equals to v is, what is v? It is 40 meter per second. So we have to write 40 square, its unit is meter per second, plus 2 into a is nothing but the g. Instead of a, we can write g also. It is acceleration due to gravity and it is negative 10 meter per second square into 2gs. S we have to find, s we have taken here h. Okay, so 0 square is will be 0 equals to 40 square will be 1600. It is 1600. See, here we have minus and here we have plus. So plus minus will be minus. So 2 into 10 will be 20 and here we have h. Okay. Now I'm going to transfer that negative part to other side. Okay. What we will get? It is 20 into h equals to 1600. So h will be what? It is 1600 divided by 20. So 0 and that 0 will get cancelled. and 2 8s are 16 and 2 0 is 0. So h will be beta. The maximum height reaches by the object will be 80 meter. Okay, it is 80 meter. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Now, we have to calculate total displacement takes place by a total distance traveled. See, it is also asking that what is the net displacement and the total distance covered by the object. See, we have thrown object from here and again it is reaches to here only. So final point and initial point is the same. Is it or not?
Yes, sir.
So displacement will be zero. So I am writing result here. Result. So first result. Height reaches, maximum height reaches by the object. Okay, the maximum height. Reaches by n stone, by the stone is, it is 80 meter. Second, the initial and final point of the stone is same. Hence, displacement will be zero. Displacement is zero. Third, I'm writing here third one because it will take more space. Okay. So third will be the distance, the total distance covered by the stone. See, when it is going to upward direction, it was taking like 80 meter and again it will reach to the same point. So again 80 meters, so 80 plus 80. So stone will be 2 into 80 meter. So it will be 160 meter. Okay. So this is nothing but our answer. Everyone got the point?
Yes, sir, got it.
Okay. Yes, sir, got it. So take a screenshot. So now we are going to cover the next question. Okay. So it is really very important one. Calculate the force of gravitation between the Earth and the Sun. OMG. Okay. Given that the mass of Earth, is 6 into 10 to the power 24 kg. And you have to remember also, most of the time it is not been given. Okay. So I'm writing first the given part. Given. So what is given? Mass of Earth. I'm just taking, it is ME, okay, mass of Earth equals to 6 into 10 to the power 24 kg. Okay. And the Sun, mass of Sun. I'm just taking MS, okay, MS. MS means mass of Sun. It is 2 into 10 to the power 30 kg. Okay. The average distance between their center is. So I'm just taking distance. Distance between their center. I'm just taking it as D. Okay. So D is 1.5 into 10 to the power 11 meter. Okay. This is the information given. So for calculating gravitational force, we will require capital G also. So capital G is universal gravitational constant, and we know the value of that. So I'm just writing, we know that. We know that. What do we know? Capital G is universal gravitational constant, and its value is 6.67 into 10 to the power minus 11. And its unit is Newton meter square per kg square, like this. Okay. Understood, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now we had to write to find part. So what we have to find? Force of attraction, force of gravitation, force of gravitation between Earth and the Sun. Earth and the Sun. That means F we had to calculate. Okay, now we have to write formula now. Formula. We had derived the value for capital, force also. What is the value for that? It is the universal gravitational constant into mass of both the objects. So here we have mass of Earth into mass of Sun divided by, it is d square. Okay, d is the distance between their center. Now we will place the value and then we will start the calculation. Okay, so I'm writing here solution. For solution, I am using other color ink. Okay. So again, we have to write one time the formula. So F equals to, we have capital G. It is mass of Earth into mass of Sun divided by distance between their center. Now I'm going to place the value. So F equals to, what is G? It is 6.67 into 10 to the power minus 11 Newton meter square and kg minus 2. Mass of earth is given here. It is into 6 into 10 to the power 24 kg into mass of sun is 2 into 10 to the power 30 kg divide by, we have distance. Distance is what? It is 1.5 into 10 to the power 11 and 11 meter. We write meter and then square. D square means the distance square. Okay. So I'm just placing these values, the 6.67, that 6 and 2 together. So F equals to 6.67 into, I'm just multiplying that 6 and that 2, we will get beta 12. So I'm writing here 12 into, now I'm just placing the value on 10th power. So here we have 10 to the power, see all the 10s, all the values, okay, here, that one here has the same base. So the power will get add and subtract. So first I'm writing 10 to the power 30. It is positive 24, so it is going to add 24. It is negative 11, so it is going to subtract. Okay. Okay, now unit. See, here we have kg and kg will be kg square. So kg minus 2 will get cancelled. Okay, so here we have now Newton meter square is remaining here. Divide by. What? See, 1.5 into 10 to the power 11 meter. So meter into meter will be meter square. And here we can write it is in square form. So 1.5 into 10 to the power 11 into 10 to the power 11, like this. So meter square and meter square will get again cancel. So the answer will come in Newton. Now next step, F equals to, so 12 into, if you will multiply that, which one? That 6 into 6, 7, wait a second, let me multiply by using Kelsey here. it is 6 12 into 6.67 will be 80.04 divide by 1.5 into 1.5, it is 2.25. Again, here we have, see, again, base are the same. So their power will going to add 10 to the power into 10 to the power 22. Okay. Now here we have to add this 30 and 24 and we will subtract 11. So 30 plus 24 will be 54 minus 11 will be 43. So here will come 10 to the power 43. Okay. Now we will transfer that 10 to the power 22 into multiple form here. So it will come like 10 to the power minus 22 in next step. So next step I'm going to solve over here. Okay. So F equals to, see here we have, it is 80 or not 80. It is 80. Okay. So here we have 80.04 divide by 2.25. So if we will solve that, it is 2.25. So we will get 35. See, almost half and less than that, because here we had 2.5 also. So we will get, if we will solve that, we will get 35.57. Okay. Then into, here we have 10 to the power 43 into 10 to the power minus 22. Again, here we have the same base. So we can again calculate that F equals to 35.57 into 10 to the power 42 minus 22. So F equals to 35.57. It is 7 into 10 to the power. 2 minus 2 is 0 and 4 minus 2 is 2. So here we will get 20. Okay. So that much of force, it is, its unit will be Newton. So that much of force is going to apply between Earth and the Sun. Okay. So here we have the answer. So now I'm going to write the result. Okay. So I'm writing result at the bottom here. Result. Let me use little darker ink. Okay. So what is going to be result now? So the result will be the force of attraction, or the force of gravitation also, the force of gravitation working between Earth and the Sun is, the force of gravitation working between Earth and the Sun is 35.57 into 10 to the power 20 Newton. And this is our answer, beta. Okay, everyone?
Yes, sir. Got it.
See, here we have 43. And here we have written 42. So just write it as 43. So 43 minus 22. 43. So it will become,
it's 21, not 20.
Yes. Yes, because instead of 43, we have wrote 42, no? Okay. So it is 21. Yeah. Like this. Okay. Now it is correct. Okay now?
Yes, sir.
Now we are going to solve the next problem. The question says, a stone is allowed to fall from the height of the tower of 100 meter. Okay, so first we have to understand the question. Suppose here we have the tower. Okay, here we have the tower and its height is from here top to the bottom is 100 meter. So it is the height. So let me write the given part here. Given. What is given? Height. Height is nothing but the displacement equals to, it is 100 meter. Okay, then At the same time, another stone is projected vertically in upward direction. Okay, so it is conceptual one. So one stone we are dropping from the height of 100 meter, and the same time we are throwing one ball on upward side, okay, with the velocity of 25 meter per second. So here we have two stones. So I am just writing the second part here. So I am just taking it is U2. Okay, U2 means initial velocity of second stone. Okay, it says it is 25 meter per second. It is 25 meter per second. Is it everyone? Just keep replying.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes.
Then projected vertically in upward direction. So for object falling down, for this object, okay, G will be positive. And for that, so I'm writing here G is, it is given value no. So we have to calculate positive 9.8. And for this, we have to take G. Here I'm just taking G1 and here G2 will be negative 9.8 meter per second square. Meter per second square. Here also meter per second square. Okay. Calculate when and where the two stones will meet. Okay. So where the stones are going to meet, okay, we have to calculate at that particular height and upward direction ground.
So when, sir, is it time or distance?
When is time?
And sir, how will we calculate time?
Oh, we'll solve that. Wait a second. And where will be the height?
Okay, sir.
Yeah. So we have to calculate time and height also. So see, if initial velocity of that object will be zero, because we are going to release from the height. So initial velocity, it is U1 equals to zero for first stone. Okay. And the final velocity will be like before touching the ground, but when they are going to meet here, so we have to calculate at that particular height. So there is no use of V here. Okay. So there is no use of V. That means we will use second equation of motion. And for here, for second stone, initial velocity is given here. Again, there is no use of second, like final velocity. Okay, before going to reach the final velocity.
Sir, but there is no.
How much?
So then time is not given, right? How can you find?
Yes, we will calculate time. We will calculate time, don't worry. Okay. Okay, so let's solve the question now. So now we have to find what we had to find, the time at which, it is time at which these two stones going to meet. Two stones means S1 and S2 going to meet. Then this is the first, means S1 and height of S1 equals to height of S2. That will be same from the surface, okay, that we had to calculate. Is it or not? We had to calculate individual height and we had to equate them, because at the same height, they are going to meet with each other. Is it or not?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So now I'm just going to write the formula, which formula we are going to use. So formula, we will use second equation of motion.
Second equation, sir?
Yes. Formula. So what is the formula? It is S equals to UT plus half of AT square. That we will use. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Yeah. So let's solve the question now. Solution. So we had to calculate height of, so I'm just writing consider part. Let let S1 is no, we will calculate S1 only first, then we will equate them. So S1 equals to, so it is UT, see U1, because initial velocity will be U here. So that's why I have taken U1 into T plus half of AT square. So instead of A, I am writing G1. Okay, G1 means what? It is acceleration due to gravity. Therefore, S1 equals to UT. What is U beta for the first stone?
Sorry, initial velocity.
Yeah, zero, initial velocity is zero. Yeah.
Zero.
So zero into T plus half. What is G? It is positive 9.8. Okay. 9.8 into T square. So S1 equals to, that part will become zero. So here we have 9.8 by 2. So what is half of 9.8? Almost, suppose
4.9.
Yes. See here, it is not given here, but in order to calculate the exact value, I'm just considering the value 10 here. 10 meter per second square, and here negative 10 meter per second square. So instead of 9.8, I'm just using 10. So calculation will become easier. Okay, if we have here written 9, 10, so the examiner is going to check the answer by 10 meter per second acceleration due to gravity. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay. So if we will solve that, 2 5s are 10. So we will get here 5t square. Just close it into the box. Okay. Let this is the first equation. Now for second stone, I'm just calculating S2 equals to, again, it is U2t plus half of G2T square, is it? So S2 yes. equals to.
Sir, yeah. Can we use V square equals to but U square plus 2GS? And over here, because it's thrown vertically upwards, then so V equals to 0, right?
See, we had to equate S1 and S2. That's why we are just calculating S part. Okay? There we can also get, but final velocity is given there, no? And
where
here
is it?
Not given here, so we cannot use the second one.
So final velocity, why do we need it? It's vertically upwards going, so V equals to zero, right?
Yes, but V is already mentioned there now. We don't know it is V going to be zero because it is not going that particular height. Because they are going to meet in between only, no? Is it or not?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's why we are not using that final velocity is zero equation. So we will use the same. It is, what is U2? U2 is, it is 25 meter per second. So I'm writing here 25 meter per second into T plus half of G2. What is G2? It is again 10 meter, but it is negative. So negative 10 into T square. So if I will solve that part, so again, it will become minus 5 T square. So S2 equals to 25 T minus 5 T square. Is it? Is it or not? So
yes,
let,
sir.
Yeah,
yes,
again, sir. We have to close it into the box. Okay. So let it is our second equation. Is it?
Yeah, sir.
Yes.
So the next part. Okay. See, total height of that tower is 100 meter. Is it? Is it or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Suppose first stone is going to fall in this direction and second stone is moving in this direction, S2. Okay. So, and they are going to meet over here. Suppose they are going to meet over here. So, distance from here to the distance of here will be 100. That S1 plus S2 will be 100 or not? Hania. Priyanshu.
What, sir?
Yes, sir.
Yes. see, we are dropping the stone from this particular height. So object will move. Suppose they are going to meet over here. So height from here to here, it is S1 plus from here to the bottom will be S2. So S1 and S2 is 100 given. Is it or not? So by the given condition, S1 plus S2 equals to 100 meter. Is it? Just do reply.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
So just
yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So let again, this is the third equation. So by equation 1, 2, and 3, we will place the value of S1 and S2 in equation number 3. So place or substitute the value of S1 and S2 in equation 3. We will get, what we will get? S1 is what? It is 5t square plus S2. What is S2? It is 25t minus 5t square, and it is equals to 100. If we will open the bracket, will become 5t square plus 25t minus 5t square equals to 100. So this is negative, this is positive, will get cancelled. So here we have 25t equals to 100. So t equals to what? 100 divided by 25. Yes. So t equals to what? 4 seconds.
4, sir.
Yeah. So they are going, see, first answer we got when. So after 4 seconds, they are going to meet with each other. Is it? Is it,
yes,
or not?
Sir.
Yeah. Now we had to calculate at what height they are going to meet with each other. So we can calculate either S1 or S2. This is the particular height at which they are going to meet. Okay. So now where? So I'm just using other color for that. So where they're going to meet? So they're going to meet at S1 or S2. So I'm just writing their formula. So by equation 1. So what is equation 1? It is S1 equals to 5t square. So S1 equals to 5 into what is t? It is 4. So 4 square. So S1 equals to 5 into 4 square is what? 16. So S1 equals to 16 5s are? 16 5s are?
80.
Yes, 80 meter. Okay. So they are going to meet at 80 meter of height.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. After 4 seconds. Okay. So here we have solved the question. Now I'm going to write the result. So can you write the result? Just answer like
yes.
That.
Yes.
This stone 1 and stone 2 going to meet at after 4 seconds at the height of 80 meter. That's all. Okay. Okay. So we are going to solve the last but not the least problem from your gravitation chapter. Okay. So the question says a ball thrown up vertically returns to the thrower after 6 seconds. Okay. So here we have the thrower, the person who is throwing the ball in upward direction. Okay. So suppose this is the position at which the thrower is moving or throwing the ball in upward direction, and it returns back to the thrower again. Okay, so total time will be 6 seconds. It is given. So the total time is means what? It is T1 plus T2 equals to 6 seconds. And we know when ball is going in upward direction and again returning back to the same position, the total time taken for both the side will be 0. Therefore, T1 equals to T2 equals to, see, the 6 second, no, if you will divide that, we will get 3 seconds. Okay, so the total time taken, or instead of that, we can solve that also. Like instead of T1, I am writing T2. So T2 plus again T2 equals to 6. So twice of T2 equals to 6. So T2 equals to 3 seconds. So, and here we have written both are equal. Therefore, T1 equals to T2 equals to 3 seconds. So we got the time now. So time, so given part, given. So T1 equals to 3 seconds. And which is again equals to T2. So what we had to find? The velocity with which it was thrown up, means we had to calculate u equals to. So it is to find part. To find. And here we know that the acceleration due to gravity, means g, is equals to 9.8. If it is not specified, so we can use 10 also or 9.8. Okay. So here, see, when ball is going in upward direction, okay, that time gravity acceleration due to gravity will be negative, and u we had to calculate, and v will be 0 meter per second. So we can calculate easily u by
using equals to 29.4.
Yeah, we'll calculate first the u. So u equals to, it is u1 when ball is going in upward direction. So we have to write condition here. When ball is throwing in upward direction. Okay. So it is u1 equals to, no, it is v equals to u plus at. It is the formula. So here I'm just writing v1 equals to u1 plus g into T. So again, I am writing here G1. So V will be the 0. V will be 0. Is it? So 0 plus U1, we have to calculate, plus what is G? G is minus 9.8. So minus 9.8. And T is what? It is 3 seconds. So 0 equals to U1 minus 9.8 into 3. So we have to multiply that. So 0, I'm just going to transfer that also to the other side after multiplication. So u1 minus, so 8 threes are 24, 24 will have 4 here and 2 will carry. 9 threes are 27 and 2 is 29, and decimal point we have after 1 point, so 29.4. I'm just transferring this to other side. So U1 will be 29.4 meter per second. So initial velocity for throwing the ball will be beta. What? It is 29 meter per second. Understood? 29.4 meter per second. Is it or not?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Now we have to calculate maximum height. So for that we can use equation second, maximum height. So this is the first part. Now I'm going to solve second part over here. Let me use the darker pen. Yeah, so maximum height, reaches by the ball. So S equals to UT plus half of AT square. So S is maximum height that we had to calculate. It is H. U is what just we have calculated. It is 29.4 into
4 T. meter per second.
T is what? 3.
Plus. Sir, 3.
Yes.
3 seconds.
Yeah, yeah. Plus half into A is what? Acceleration due to gravity, again 9.8 into T is what? T is 3, so square of 3. Okay, so H equals to 29 into 3, 3 fourths are 12 one will carry here
88.2.
88.2, sure?
Yes, sir.
Yes, 88.3 plus half of. See, we just calculate that half into 9.8 will be 4.6 into square of 9 will be 3 will be.
Sir, it won't be 4.6, it's 4.9.
9, yes, 4.9. Yeah, it is 4.9. And square of 3 will be 9. Okay. Now we had to here 9.8 is negative or what? Yes, 9.8 is negative na here. So we had to calculate in negative form. So it will be negative over here. Okay, so that will become negative now. So H equals to 88.2 minus. Just multiply 4.9 into 9. So
4.9
into 9 will be 44.1. Now we have to subtract that. So H equals to, so it is
44.1.
44.1 and it is in meter.
Meter per second.
Yeah. So we have solved the second problem also, B. It is second means it is B. And it is A. Okay. Now its position after 4 seconds. Okay. So we have to calculate position after 4 seconds. So I'm using another thing for that, the red one, and we are going to solve over here. Okay. So the portion C, height of the ball at 4th second. Is it? So T is equals to 4. Is it or not? Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
So 4, 3 means ball is returning back. Yes. So S equals to again
29.4.
Just let me calculate. So it is S equals to UT plus half of GT square will be the formula. So S equals to S means S is already, we know that. No, we have to calculate height at that particular means S we have to calculate. So U is what? It is 29.4. So 29.
So we can't use this formula, right?
No, we can use that, beta. Because we have.
Because it will return, right? It returns.
Yes.
So how can you calculate it? I did it by I checked if 1 second how many meters it is traveling, and then by that way I did.
See, what this is the total distance tablet is given? No, it is not given.
44.1.
Yeah, maximum height is given over here.
Yeah, 44.1 meters.
Yes, maximum height is given over here.
So you can divide it by 3 and you'll get 14.7. Yes. And then you need to minus it from 44.1.
But it is accelerating, no, beta. It is accelerating. So we cannot calculate 44. It is a third 44.1 divided by 3. Okay, we cannot calculate like this because the velocity of throwing or the object is going in upward direction or in downward direction. It is accelerating. At every point, its velocity is being changing. That's why you have to go through the formula, not directly. Okay? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So it is 29.4 into T is 4, plus half. G is what it is? -9.8 into T is what it is? 4 square. So S equals to just calculate 29.4 into 4. Let me calculate 29.4 into 4 will be 117.6. See, here we have negative and positive, so answer will come negative. So again, we have to calculate that, so we will get 4.9. So 4.9 into square of 4 is 16. So S equals to 117.6 minus. So 16 into 4.9. It is 4.9, na? Yes, 4.9. Will be 78.4. Yeah. So 78.4. Just subtract that from 117.6. So you will get 39.2. So S equals to 39.2 meter. Yeah.
Yes, sir.
So this is the height of that ball at after 4 seconds. Okay, that means it is again returning back, no? Because maximum height is 44.1 meter. Means it is returning back at that particular height. Okay, so I hope you have understood all the 3 points A, B, and C for the given question. Is it?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so take a screenshot for that. And here we have completed numericals of the gravitation chapter. I have uploaded last video in YouTube, and again I'm going to upload this video on YouTube. So whenever you are getting any kind of doubt, just go through the questions. Okay, just watch this video again so that you will clarify all your doubt regarding the questions and their solution. Okay, everyone. Just do reply.
Yes, sir.
Okay.